Hi, everybody. I previously made a step-by-step tutorial on how to create and list an NFT on Rarible. Since then, a great new feature has been added to allow you to post your art without paying gas fees. It's called lazy minting. It is turned on by default, and it's similar to other gasless minting options available on sites like Mintable and Opensea. I'll show you how to use it, but first let's discuss exactly what is happening when you use lazy or gasless minting. When you post your art with lazy minting, your artwork becomes available on the Rarible site and will appear on Rarible like other NFTs would. But it's not technically an NFT yet because it hasn't been minted to the Ethereum blockchain. Your art and information is being stored on the Interplanetary File System, or IPFS, which is basically a big decentralized file storage system. If and when a buyer decides to purchase your artwork, then the NFT is minted and the buyer will pay the purchase price and the gas fee for minting. Minting means actually creating the NFT and writing it to the blockchain. If you wish to transfer the quote NFT to another wallet, you'll have to pay the gas fees at that time to mint the NFT and then transfer it. The great part of this is you can post as much artwork as you want without paying gas fees or any other fees at all for that matter. If you don't sell anything, no gas fees are ever paid. And if you've paid attention to Ethereum gas prices lately, you'll know that is very, very good. The downsides are that you have not fully created an NFT, and although it's available to view on Rarible, it's not actually on the Ethereum blockchain, and therefore it won't show up on places like OpenSea or Etherscan. Also, if you decide you want to destroy or burn the almost NFT, you will actually have to pay gas fees to do so. No idea why, but that's how it works. Another possible downside is it's an additional cost to the buyer, sort of. The buyer has to pay the purchase price and the minting fees. Although, there has always been a gas fee to create and then transfer the NFT, so this could actually save on overall fees, and I'm not sure how much more it ends up costing the buyer. Gas fees could be a couple hundred dollars right now. They fluctuate a lot, so if you're trying to sell your NFT for $20, remember that the buyer will also have to pay the minting fees on top of that. Currently, lazy minting is only available when posting to the Rarible collection. If you've created your own collection, it's not yet available for that. But it is available for both one-of-one NFTs and multiples. Multiples are when you want to create more than one copy of the same NFT. So let's jump into Rarible and list a piece of digital art for sale without paying any gas fees. Connect to Rarible with MetaMask or the wallet of your choice. I've got an entire video on how to set up MetaMask if you need it. Let's click Create. We've got an option to create a one-of-one or to create multiple copies of the NFT. I will select Single. Upload your file here, or just drag and drop your artwork. I'm uploading a recent animation I created in Blender. When you upload a video, it opens an option for a cover, which is like a preview image. I don't honestly know if this is required, so we will find out together. I will not add one. Next is the option to place the art for sale when it is uploaded. Obviously, we want to do that, so we will leave it checked. And then you have to choose how you want your art listed for sale. You can choose to list it at a fixed price in Ethereum. You can have it open for bids, which allows anyone to submit a bid of any price. Or you can do a timed auction where you place the piece on auction for a set period of time and then can choose the minimum bid amount. By the way, when this timed auction ends, the art will be open to bids, like in the second option. I will choose to have it open for bids. You can choose to have content unlocked when you purchase it. I covered that fairly thoroughly in my other tutorial. Next, you can choose your collection. The first option, to create your own collection, will require you to pay Ethereum, and remember that lazy minting is not yet available in custom collections. So you'll need to choose Rarible Singles to use lazy gasless minting. And here we come to the lazy minting option, which is turned on by default. It says the buyer will pay minting fees, and it says, quote, "Your item won't be minted in blockchain. Your NFT will be stored for further minting by buyer." So let's leave it checked. Really quick, if you made it this far, thank you. And giving the video a like is a huge help with me on YouTube. So next you give the NFT a name, you add a description of your choosing, and all of this, by the way, is permanent once you move past this page, so choose carefully. Choose a royalty. This is how much commission you will earn for any sale after the first sale. So if I sell it to you for one ETH, ETH is short for one unit of Ethereum, I keep that. But when you sell it to someone else for two ETH, I'll get 0.2 ETH from that sale, forever. 10% seems fairly standard, and the maximum is 50%. They've moved a couple things to advanced settings. Here you can list any sort of properties you want to list and give them a value. I've been putting both the year and the actual creation date on mine. These fields are entirely optional, and they are entirely up to you what you want to put in them. Another option down here in the advanced section is alt text for your image. Now let's hit create item. Remember, this is forever unless you at some point want to pay gas fees to burn this. So double check everything before you hit this button. So Rarible will first upload your art to the IPFS. It will then begin the minting process, and you'll have to sign with your MetaMask wallet or whatever other wallet you have. Then it will process the unlimited auction, which is what I chose by listing it as open for bids. We will have to sign a second time, but at no time did it show a cost in Ethereum, because there isn't any. This process can actually take a few minutes. Don't worry if it does. And success. The quote, NFT is created and now we can view it. Well, it's not actually fully created because it won't be until somebody chooses to buy it and pay for the minting. Oh, and it turns out we did not have to upload that preview image after all. So now this can all be viewed on Rarible. Just for fun, let's see what the gas fees would have been to mint this. I'll do everything exactly the same, but I will turn off lazy minting. And the estimated gas fees are $161. I don't know about you, but I cannot justify paying that to create an NFT that, in all honesty, will probably never sell. But if someone does want to buy it, they can now place a bid and pay the fees themselves. So if I move over to OpenSea and look at my profile, it shows the NFTs I've actually minted. It does not show this NFT because it hasn't been minted to the Ethereum blockchain. So it's not even technically an NFT yet. It's just listed for sale on Rarible and only on Rarible. But if I go to my profile on Rarible, it is there and it displays along actual NFTs I own and a few others that I've listed with the lazy minting option. And that is how you use lazy gas fee minting on Rarible. My name is Brandon. I do not claim to be an absolute expert on NFTs, but I hope this helps. My original video about Rarible goes into a little more detail. It just predated the lazy minting feature. And feel free to post links to your NFTs in the comments. If you've made it this far, I would very much appreciate a like on the video because it helps me out a lot with YouTube. My channel is a mix of Blender tutorials and a few NFT videos. If that's up your alley, I would love to have you as a subscriber. I would also love to see you on Instagram where I post my art. Have fun, good luck with NFTs, and stay creative.